That orangey peel in my sight has stayed with me even after many years. You dug into the flesh of it with manicured nails, cutting into the craters, slicing with your thumb, pulling back and up with your wrist to expose the naked navel. My thirst was excited, waiting in elation for juice to glaze your lips as my eyes hung above your chest in the glare of the ceiling fan universe. You sat with your back to a window that dripped with December's condensation and teased the panting morning sun as it shattered against your rolling shoulder blades. Every moving morning limb of yours dipped your shadow into and out of the cup of coffee you poured for me. Listening to those tones, your voice develops in your sleep, its highs and slowly melting lows, as you talk to me about your childhood in Mexico. You said how there the red dirt you walked on was hard, and about how the low amber sky that softly danced on your curly brown hair did not forget to blanket the mountains that you never climbed. But I stopped listening when your long fingers, dripping with juice, lifted the first wedge of that fruit. I watched you bleed into your mouth, the orange pulp, its white membrane, the citric taste, as you lifted your left foot and slammed the heel of it against the fold of your ass, leaving your unpainted toes to dangle from the edge of the chair, curling and pointing down at a cracked square of tile. After you talk just a little bit more, those eyes that try to pull back from telling me stories of bonfires lit off California coast dilate in passion as they look down on the pith of the orange that remains bleeding for life on a table. I raise my cup unsteadily, my heart still embracing what my eyes saw, and I took a sip, knowing you'd continue to say whatever it was you wanted to say once you'd stop biting down on your lip. Tomorrow I'll wake before the fog lifts, before you roll out of bed. I'll walk outside to pick you an orange and wait in anticipation again at our table. I'll wait there passing my faintly scented fingers over the top of my lip 100, maybe 101 times, until I hear your bare feet sluggishly striking a square patterned tile floor. My eyes reflect your hair that was mangled from blankets that swirled over and beneath us, but never found a place between us. We kiss the taste of each other's salted flesh on our breath, and again you sit where you sat after I picked your orange the first time.